Okay, so this is a little bit more of a tricky one. Where most people get tripped up is differentiating sugar maple from red maple. And so I'm gonna explain sugar maple largely in terms of red maple. So watch the red maple video and you'll sort of identify them against each other. Sugar maple has this, to my eye, grayish brown bark. It's much lighter in color than red maple. And it'll have this actually really distinctive whitewashed appearance sometimes. So sometimes you can just look through the forest and it looks like a whole bunch of trees have just been splashed with whitewash or with white paint up and down their trunk. And that can be a very distinctive trait that will help you know that it's sugar maple. When sugar maple trees are young, their bark can be held very tightly to the stem. It will never be completely smooth like a young red maple or a young American beech. It'll always be kind of warty and rough and sandpapery to the touch. As sugar maple trees get older, their bark will start to break up into these kind of vertical ridges or plates. The bark is thick and it's held very tightly to the tree. So you should never be able to just pop a piece of that bark off with your thumb. This is the example of a sugar maple tree with what we would call tighter bark. So it's just the bark of a younger, faster growing tree. It hasn't formed those big thick plates yet, but it's starting to break up into these vertical cracks. This is also that whitewash that I'm talking about. So this sort of splosh of this really white coloration against the side of the tree. If you do have the twig of a sugar maple tree, you can see that like ash, it's opposite branched. That's true for both red maple and sugar maple. Unlike red maple, however, sugar maple twigs are brown and they're tipped with these pointy brown buds. Sugar maple leaves and red maple leaves look similar. They both have this multi-pointed appearance. The main difference is that while red maple leaves are serrated or jagged all the way around the margin of the leaf, the sugar maple leaf has all these little points, but between the points is actually smooth. In our forest, sugar maple tends to be an indicator of enriched sites, so sites with soils that are more rich in calcium and magnesium. It is shade tolerant, often growing in the understory of the forest and sort of pushing its way up through the canopy. And it is long-lived, capable of living for 250 or 300 years. All of these things are very different than red maple. So red maple is a generalist. It can grow kind of anywhere. It is less tolerant of shade than sugar maple, and it's relatively short-lived, living more like 80 to 100 years.